There was a time in YouTube fitness where unconventional lifts got popular. And to be honest with you, I don't think it was a bad thing. Yeah, there were some obvious flaws, which I'm going to talk about in today's video, but overall, when I analyzed things objectively, there were a lot of benefits, so allow me to go over the pros and cons. First things first, unconventional lifts forced us to lift heavy. These were not lightweight fluff and pump movements. No, we had guys maxing out, putting up serious poundages to the point of even comparing them to classical lifts, pushing our limits, doing rep work with appropriate percentages, actually emphasizing progressive overload. We saw new standards coming out every single day. We saw people documenting their progress, and you know what? It worked. Guys were getting real results because they were training like real naturals, not fluff and pump garbage, not what has unfortunately resurfaced in YouTube fitness and especially Instagram, where guys are performing a bunch of different lightweight movements without any form of progression, and they're usually very fluffy in nature in the way that they're not time proven whatsoever, and move completely away from the basics. Because here's the thing. Yeah, the unconventional lifts were unconventional, right? But they still incorporated the major movement patterns. And you still got carryover, provided that you got strong as hell. Remember, strength is strength. So if you're able to zert your squat 4 or 5 for reps, well, your back squat would already be up there. If you're doing landmine presses with 5 plates, your OHP would already be advanced or even elite. If you're doing a lot of metals rows, you would go and do the dumbbell stack, easy as hell. Max it out, no problem. Behind the back deadlifts, if you could pull more than 6 plates, you'd already be strong at most pulling variations. High handle trap bar deadlifts, same thing. Even Jefferson's, hell. For me, Jefferson deadlifts, even to this day, are harder than sumo deadlifts. I'm not even joking about that. When you pull from the ground, they're insanely difficult. So some of these exercises were either easier or harder than the classical lifts. So regardless, it forced us to train with intensity. At the same time, it was a big screw you to the elitism that existed back then, because there was a lot of it. I'm telling you right now, bro, the bias was unbelievable. In my opinion, there was excessive minimalism and way too much emphasis on classical lifts only. And anything else was considered useless and a waste of time, and just these biased, dogmatic ways of thinking that are factually incorrect on all levels. So unconventional lifts brought out that creativity in all of us and allowed us to perform movements that were pretty damn good. Like behind the back deadlifts build tremendous leg drive for all pulls from the ground. You can use them today to actually raise your conventional deadlift. Feel amazing on the lower back due to the leverages involved. Louis Simmons talks about that exercise. A lot of old school strongmen used to do it as well. And I'm certainly going to dabble with it. Why would I dismiss it just because it's not part of a competition? So what I'm saying is that there was lots of variety. It's kind of like comparing them to specialty barbells. That's literally what these lifts were. Same thing for the Jeffersons. We had a unilateral pull that was pretty athletic. A lot of wrestlers were using this. And there's so many lifts that I can mention. Hell, the boom of arm wrestling, which I talked about years before, how that's one of the secrets to getting huge forearms as a natural. Things like that, you know? The uniqueness, the creativity aspect, and just escaping dogmatism and enjoying your training and actually getting real results. So when I compare the unconventional lifts to what I'm seeing now, which is just fluff and pump garbage, literally what a roided out bodybuilder would do, the alternative is much better. So those are some of the good things that happened back then. Now I want to go over the cons, and there's quite a few, to be real. And this is where a lot of the controversy started, right? The main issue is that we had a bunch of weak novices doing these exercises when they really had no business. Instead, focusing on the fundamentals should have been emphasized. What I mean is we had guys deadlifting 135 for 5 reps, going in doing behind the back deads. Or a dude who's overhead pressing 55 pounds, trying to specialize in landmine presses. Or a guy who has trouble curling 15 to 20 pounds, trying to train like a professional arm wrestler. And then the worst thing was taking these unconventional lifts and turning them into extreme partials and then using that to demonstrate strength, which I'm guilty of doing myself. Okay, you've seen me do 1,000-pound Jefferson rack pulls and all that, but we had novices doing that. This was the problem. They didn't have a base level of strength. Like when you saw me doing all these partials, I was already strong. You can look at my numbers back then. I wasn't some noob. I knew how to lift. And I was doing concurrent periodization for years already. Just that when I started rotating the variations, I started adding in these partials. And a lot of these variations were mainly for the yoke, or I was doing it in a progressive range of motion fashion, right? But it led to the point where you had novices doing like behind the back rack pulls above the knee, doing like Zercher holds with stupid heavy weights, and they weren't building their foundation. And then we saw the progression was slowed down for a lot of these guys. So when implemented in the wrong way, which did happen a lot, I'm not gonna lie, we saw things that were just not optimal in any type of way. Then we had guys comparing strength, saying that it's equal to the classical lifts. Like a six plate hack deadlift is not equivalent to a six plate conventional. The hack is gonna be easier for most people. There are exceptions. I know there's a guy at the Westside gym who did a 600 hack, 700 conventional. So we do have that going on in some cases, but most people, they can lift a little bit more, right? Kind of confused the strength world because people didn't know where they stood anymore. They were like, am I advanced? Am I intermediate? Where the hell am I, you know? And some people got pissed off at this. Now, there was a lot of slander involved as well. Like you had guys claiming that behind the back deadlifts will add 200 pounds to your conventional pull. Complete nonsense for the vast majority of lifters unless you're a freak with really crazy leverages, right? So that was certainly a factor. And then we had certain dudes completely avoiding the classical lifts, like 100%, and never dressing to weaknesses. Like they would just stay in a comfortable range, do what they're good at exclusively. Never get out of their comfortable zone. And as I'm always talking about on this channel, you want to dress your weaknesses. You want to do what you're terrible at. And if you're only good at the unconventional lifts, say because of your leverages, or you just generally prefer them, but now you're not gonna do some of the foundational lifts, you're gonna go completely away from the basics, that's where we got a problem. So I think if we go back to eliminating black and white thinking and recognize that these are all tools in the toolbox, that's where we can draw the right conclusions. So for someone who's wanting to raise their deadlift, I would definitely include some behind the backs once in a blue moon. You can use that as a part of your exercise rotation. Again, treating these as specialty barbells. There's genuinely nothing wrong with that. Escaping black and white thinking is definitely the way to go. And when you properly use some of these exercises, the benefits are definitely real. And again, you have to avoid some of the problems that I talked about in today's video, because when used correctly, you can definitely benefit. And besides that, there's not much I can really say. I don't think it was a bad time. There were certainly some benefits, but some obvious cons as well. I hope this video was helpful. Give me your feedback down below. Let me know if you agree or disagree with what I'm saying. And that's it. I'll talk to you in the next one.